seventh day his blessing, and he hallowed it. For on it he ceased from all his work, that by creating God had made. Absolute, ultimate reality is. Pure potential for awareness, simply aware. Full with everything, yet empty of anything. Embracing all space-time, yet occupying none. Containing the largest, filling the tiniest, always newly becoming, yet ever perfectly completed. Everything nothing, as a whole, is absolute reality, where point and no point are identical, none and infinity are one. Non-dimensional singularity. Truth is. The fundamental fiction function that creates the universe within the original potential for awareness is falseness, or not. The very root function of consciousness, negation, divides the invisible, indivisible whole into two parts, is and is not, are. The very essence of duality, of relativity, of similarity and difference, other. Self and non-self, here and not here, now and not now, I am and I am not, true and false. As the universe stems from falseness, it is said to be an illusion. But you want release from suffering. Why else seek realization? Why else put up with all this bullshit? Enough with clever word combinations. Where's the beef? driven by the peculiar desire to end desire. And suffering from fear of suffering. Here you are. You who are about to die. What's born dies. So where's the beef? But was I ever born? Who am I, anyway? Are you not just I, just as I am? No difference. No other. I am. Never born. And ever reborn. As everyone. Actually happening. Here. Now. Forever.
Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, the twinkling of an eye. At the last trumpet.
Charlie figures that his friend Terry might enjoy having Daddy's workbench top, which is a peculiar and interesting sort of burden of its own. This is the workbench that at age, I don't know, I think 5, but maybe 7 or something, I could just see over the top of when Daddy did something or taught me something about tools or something in the basement. And it's one of the heart attachments with Daddy. The vacuum tube voltmeter that I helped him build at age something like 8 or 10 or whatever, also partly on the workbench top, partly on a card table or something in the living room. The vacuum tube voltmeter, for which I have absolutely no use, has been consigned to the trash. And along with it, some of the power supplies that I built and used for 100 years or something, which, being of no commercial value, were not stolen by Jay. I had a thought that actually, at this point, I love Gabi so much, so well, or so truly, or something, that I would, I feel clearly I might not refuse to take her back after she might have had an affair, after she would have, God forbid, had an affair with another man. Amen.